This world shall know pain. Almighty push. I got brought in the land. Took the wheel in the gun. Put the cards in the scouts. In the list in the gun. Legacies, gun. And see them like a gun. Go on the head of my town. The killings on the gun.
Welcome to Mobile Legends.
Pro Players doesn't tell you this, so listen carefully. Go to control settings every start of the game and set the correct control settings for your game style and type of hero. Do you notice that some players' hero are confused with what to do? They want to pursue the running enemy with low HP, but their hero is attacking the tank. The key to this is set the correct control setting for your game style. Let me explain what you just need. Choose the lowest HP if you are playing marksman role. Always, your hero will attack the enemy with the lowest number of HP. And when playing fighters or assassins, use the closest target because you're a melee attacker. And your priority should be killing the squishy hero first, like mage, marksman, or the most strategic hero to kill first. This option will attack the hero closest to you, no matter what their HP bar. If you're playing tank, support, or mage role, you can choose either lowest HP or closest target, depends on your type of skill and your priority strategy to kill the enemy. Practice using the advanced aim mode. Most players use this. Small buttons for attacking minion and tower, and the big ones for heroes. This information is important for many heroes in game style, and the other options are seldom used for a few specific heroes. Hey guys, welcome to my channel made for ML solo players. If you are a solo player like me, I know your frustrations. AFK, feeding, and less experienced teammates, they have no strategies and they play like AIs. So you are stuck in Grandmaster, Epic, or Legend, and you cannot reach the Mythic rank. I already break this curse. I'm a solo player but Mythic rank tier. In my videos, I will teach you advanced strategies for solo players to increase your chances of winning ranked games. Playing Mobile Legends is easy. It's a repetitive game. You just memorize the strategies and see yourself rank up to Mythic. So subscribe now and don't forget to like the video later. If you are playing marksman role, you should know the 7 minutes marksman priority. It is the goal to build 3 items in less than 7 minutes, the boots and 2 core damage items. Note the time and farm as fast as possible. Last hit gold lane minions and push tower. Focus on farming until you get your core items. Avoid team fights, but only join if it's happening on your lane and nearby jungle. If you manage to build 3 items in less than 7 minutes, your team have the upper hand already. For my skill, having my 3 core items in less than 7 minutes, I will win that rank game for sure. After 7 minutes, initiate team fights, kill the enemies, push turrets, keep farming, and wait for the first lord to respawn. And take down the lord after you kill 2 core heroes of the enemies. And then chat your team. Let's end the game. This will make your teammates play like they want to end the game. Signal, gather your teammates with the lord, and then end the game. Don't give second chance to the enemies. end the game as soon as possible, because a comeback is always possible. Because some heroes are made for late game fights, just like Aldous. If you didn't manage to end the game at the first lord, I'm sure you can end the game with the second lord. Just repeat the process, push, farm, and kill them, and wait for the second lord, and then take down the lord after killing two corpses, and then end the game. If the game reaches 14 minutes above, the marksmen have the potential and responsibility to carry the game. Remember, you are playing solo. Items. Build the right items for your heroes. It's okay to copy the build of pro players as your default items, but you should know how to counter build. If you're fighting against regeneration, lifesteal, and shield heroes like Uranus, Esmeralda, Balmond, Sylvana, and Harith, if the player is very good using these heroes, they are almost unkillable, right? If there's five of you attacking them, and still you cannot kill them, and that makes your teammates feeling hopeless. The counter item for these heroes is these two. Sea Halberd if your physical damage, and Necklace of Durance if your magic damage. Notice the small broken heart to the enemies after attacking them. That's the effect of this item. It reduces the regeneration or shield effects by huge percentage, making them soft and easier to kill. The support role hero should be the one to build this item, but since you are playing solo, many players out there are ignorant about this, so build it, and thanks to you for carrying your team. Map awareness. You should keep your eye on the minimap for the following reasons. If you are not seeing enemy heroes on the minimap, always assume that they are coming for you. Especially if you're alone. So retreat to a safe place like turrets or hide in bushes and warn others. Secondly, you will see in the map your teammates. Decide if they need help, going for a kill, gank or push. You will also see in the map where are the enemies going and what could be the next move. Like for example, a driving Johnson. You can avoid this car accident if you keep your eye on the map. Or when the enemy is going to other lanes, where's the direction they are heading before they vanish in the map? So you should always keep your eye on the minimap.
I'm walking alone, the streets are empty. The only thing I can see is my own silhouette. I'm
getting stronger. Step by step, the clock is ticking, but there's no time for me. I've been flying from town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe trying to protect your soul.